Lovely, yeah, so I've got two bands. One's a bit weaker and one's a bit thicker. So thicker one is harder, but either or, I'm gonna just pop them down. We're gonna do a warm up, get the arms warm. I'm gonna do some work without the bands and then we'll add the resistance. So let's have a little bit of a warm up. We'll roll the shoulders. Nice big movements. Roll them forwards. And then hands on the shoulders, making big elbow circles. Really try and get those elbows up, back and together. Thinking of your posture as well, just giving your tummy a little squeeze. Reverse. Lovely, let's take it to nice big four circles, nice and gentle. And forwards. Lovely, let's take one arm at a time, follow it back. You can twist the body as well. Other arm. Follow the arm with the head, a little bit of neck warm up. Other arm, come forward, follow it with the head, maybe a little circle with the head. Switch sides. Lovely, so let's get the warm up is going to be sort of getting the arms. The exercises we're going to do are going to warm up as well. So instead of the arms being to the side or in front, we want them on the diagonal. So pretty much everything today is going to be done in 32, but this exercise is just the arms here, but we're going to change hand position. So start with your hands facing upwards, up, two, lovely. Just about shoulder height, on the diagonal, nice and strong. So like you're presenting a tray of drinks upwards. So just to shoulder height. Lovely. Halfway there. So what I'm going to do is change the hand position. What I want to do is place facial palms to each other and carry on. Nice and gentle, just reach in, nice strong arms, shoulders down, squeeze the tummy. Lovely, for the last 16, turn your thumbs down and continue, lovely. And warming up the shoulders, but also working different parts of the shoulder. Lovely, we've got 8 more here. Lovely. Then I'm going to take the arms here, just nice and gentle, and I'm just going to take them down and up and down and up. Lovely. And we're trying not to let the chest lift, so that stays closed, just the arm. And it's more about the up than it is the down, because we're trying not to rotate the shoulders down, we're trying to open them up. Lovely, and again, one. A little bit quicker. Again, just 32 of everything, and then we start to add some resistance. So this is warming up, but it is working out as well. Last 8. Lovely, let's just give these a little shake for a second. Then we're going to take them back up. I'm going to do a gentle chest press, a little bit slower. Squeeze together and open. And squeeze and open. So we're squeezing the elbows together and we're working these muscles in the chest. On the way back, squeeze back so we open the chest. Squeeze the shoulders back. Squeeze. Squeeze. Keep the shoulders down. Lovely, last 8. Six, got 2 more, then we're going to keep the elbows together. Keep them together, push up. 16, 1, 2. Don't worry if you can't get them together, just try. Last 8, 8, and 7, 6, 5, four, squeeze those elbows and release, lovely. Whew. A little bit more for these shoulders, so that's quite a lot here. And get the tops of the shoulders warm. Let's take the arms to the side, palms down, just little circles backwards. 3, 4, 5, 6, lovely, 7, 8. Squeeze the tummy, foot up tall. Again, 1, 2, 8, another 8, and then we're gonna reverse. Let's do forward, we've got 32, 1, 2, 3, last one, 4, lovely release, slightly different. What I want to do is just get a little bit into these wrists as well. So we're going to, like you're cleaning your windows, you're going to come in for 4. We're going to go out for 4. We're going to do that, obviously. One in and out is 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's 1. 2. 3. Last one. Then we're going to take the arms up as if we're cleaning the ceiling. So we're going up, 2, 3, 4, and down, 6, 7, 8. Up, 2, 3, 4, down, 6, 7, 8. Up. One more. Lovely. Let's just take these arms across and open. Loosen them up. We'll have a little mini stretch before we grab the bands. Good. So shoulders, everything's fired up, nice and warm. Take one arm across. Pull it, keep this shoulder down. And just to add a little stretch, you can turn the thumb down. It just slightly changes the stretch, gets a little bit into that shoulder a bit further. And release, let's change sides. And let's turn that arm down. Try and keep the shoulder down. Release, let's take the arms up. Let's take one hand behind the shoulder blades and just gently take that arm back, stretching. Change sides, other hand. Lovely. Let's just take your hands together. Reach up, stretch, lift one shoulder up and down, and the other one, and then release, and then bring the front back of your hands to me, stretch the upper back, chin tucked in slightly, stretch the shoulders apart. Then the reverse of that is the hands behind and just stretch back. So we stretch the chest, but we squeeze the shoulder blades back as well. Lovely. And release, good. So we're gonna grab a band. So we're gonna start with biceps, this part of the arm. I tend to find that if you're taking your arms away from the body and they're long, a lighter band is better. But when you've got a short, shorter range of motion, you probably go a bit stronger. But if you've only got one band, just stick to the one. Bicep curl, nice and easy. So this one hand is going to hold the band here, and this one is going to curl. So you're going to have to find where, you know, this hand's going to go to make your band have enough tension so you can feel the arm working. 32 of these. You could always twist your band, you know, work with your level. But arm in, obviously in this position. Ready, here we go. 1. As you go, you'll know your own resistance. 2, 3. So we're lengthening the muscle. So the band is always under tension. 1. Think of the muscle you're working. You're contracting the arm. And you're not locking it out on the way down. That is 8. Lovely stuff. So we probably only get one exercise in of everything, but we repeat a lot. I think we preferred that, didn't we? We've been doing that last few weeks. You really get that muscle. Once the muscle is starting to fatigue, that's when it really starts to work, even though that doesn't sound right in your brain. That's when you're really starting to train it. Halfway through, one. Squeeze. Oh, I can feel it. I can feel it. Last eight of these biceps. One, two. Hang in there. Ooh, good. Feel that one. Have a little shake. We're going to switch sides. Again, this one's going to be the tight one. This one in here, shoulders down. Holding it wherever you need to. And no, one side could be stronger than the other. Here we go. Up and down. So trying to always keep the tension. You want to try not to pull it too much so your arm is not pulling across the body. So you've got to try and find your... where your tension is. Good, that's eight. One. Think of the muscle you're working. Breathe into it. Halfway through. 16 left. One. Really feeling that muscle firing up now. We've got our last eight here. Really nice and controlled, lovely. Four, five, six, two more, seven. Woo! Release. Let's just have a little stretch back. So, because we've worked the triceps, the biceps, get it right. That's the biceps, and whilst that one's working, this is relaxing. So now we're going to do the opposite. We're going to work the tricep and let the bicep relax. So, very similar. Just going to hold the, have your arm across your shoulder like that, and then this hand in the band so you can pull it down. So a couple of things to know. We want to try not to rotate that shoulder down. Keep your shoulder back, elbow back, and pull down. Because we're always trying not to sort of over impinge or over rotate the shoulders, and it's just a push down and back. Ready, here we go. One, two. So just think of standing up tall, that should keep the shoulder back. And again, there's tension quite a lot of the time, the arm doesn't lock out, you can see it shaking. Try and have your wrist strong so that your band isn't sort of flipping your wrist like that. Try and have your palm facing you. That's eight down, eight. Seven. Breathing into it, thinking of your posture as well. A little squeeze of the tummy. Good, that's halfway through these. 16 left. Think of the muscle you're working, the back of that arm. Oh, really feeling that. We've got eight left. One. And then switch sides. So again, rather than having your hand like that, have your hand that way, and it will stop you from hurting the wrist too much. Shoulder back and go. One, two, three, four. It's quite nice here where I was just resting like in a sling. Good, that's eight down already. Keep on going. Keep that tension in the band, slow on the way back as well. We are halfway through, only 16 left of these. One. Halfway through the workout already. Should start to feel that burn. We've got our last day. Hang in there. Ooh, two more. Oh, well done. Have a little release stretch. Arms up, stretch back. And then let's stretch one of the triceps. And switch. Lovely. Okay. I am going to take a slightly lighter band now, but I have just got a bit of a dodgy shoulder at the moment. So we're going to do a lat raise. You can see my arm is slightly bent and it's out, and it's these sort of muscles under here, you're squeezing down like you're trying to squeeze a balloon. So again, to do that, we can just hold this on the side and we're just, the band is creating resistance, okay? Again, nice soft knees, pull up tall. Here we go, one. So you just come to shoulder height. And we're trying to get tension in the band, so you're predominantly working shoulder on the way up, but your lats as well. That's eight, one. Again, nice straight wrist. And try not to have your hand too bent when you're lifting. Try and have it out here a little bit. Just otherwise it can become a bit of an upright row if it's like that. Lovely. We've got eight more. So your arm is to the side, out to the side, to the leg. Four more. Lovely. Oh, let's switch sides. Again, it's lifting here, so try and have the band on top so you're lifting it up rather than pulling it. You're kind of resisting against it. Okay, ready? Here we go. Six, seven, eight, up. Lovely, good. And your elbow and your wrist are kind of the same height. You're not leading with the elbow, you're not leading with the wrist. Good, that is 16, halfway there. One, two, three. We've got eight more, feeling those shoulders work. So now we're going to continue with these sort of lats a bit more. We're going to do a lat pull down. So if you're in a gym, you have those bars that you pull down. So that's what we're going to do, one arm at a time. So this arm is just going to hold the band still, however high you want it. And this one is going to pull it down and back up. So it's like your arm is coming down to your waist, going back up in a sort of triangle type shape. Ready? 32. Again, however high you've got this arm up, it's going to make you work harder. You're working the shoulders, shoulder pull down. Lovely stuff, really nice. Again, think of that posture, tummy in, tight. I've got my feet particularly far apart, that's so you can fit me in the camera angle. You haven't got me that far apart, just soft knees. Halfway through, squeeze. So feel your shoulder blades squeezing down your back. Feeling this sort of here, not just the shoulder, underneath the shoulder as well. Last eight, seven, and then we're just going to switch sides. Four, three, two, one. Let's switch sides. That's ready to pull down. This is holding here, and one. Two, three, four. So elbow towards the body. Six, seven, eight. Lovely. One, two, three, four. That's 16, halfway there. One.
as well.
4, 3, 2, and 1. Oh. Okay, a little bit of maintenance for the shoulder, a bit of a slower move. And this time, what I'm going to do is the arm here is out in front, and you try not to reach it too far, so it's out, but it's here. And we're just taking it out to the sides. Again, it's this opening rotation. But what I want to do is hold this arm still, a little bit more to the centre of you, and this one is opening. So this one's got to resist, because when you pull, that one wants to move. So this is still as your anchor, and then this one is going to pull out to the side, and it isn't too big. So shoulders back and down, squeeze the tummy, here we go. 1, 2, and again, there's constant tension. 3. Very good for your shoulders. Good, that's 8. 1. Try and keep this other arm still, resist it, pulling across. Halfway there, we can do it. Hey, more. Keep the shoulders down, keep that tummy tight. 4, 3, 2, 1. We see that other arm starting to tire and sag a bit. Then we're reversing it. So this arm is our anchor, this one's pulling out, and we're trying to keep this one still. Here we go. 3. It's going to be more tired now, this arm that's staying still, because it's just been pulled against. God, this arm's so much weaker. Again, you can make it smaller. Halfway through. Ow, I can feel this, because this arm's already had to work. Oh, we've got 8 more. Can we do it? Yes, we can. Here we go. 8. 4. Oh, let's have a little release before we move on. Let's hold the hands, stretch them back. Feel those chest stretch open. Well done. That's a tough one. Really good for those shoulders. So one more little exercise. That's what we've got, yeah. So this one is, there's slight tension on the band, so not much. So your arms are just here. And I want them to stay in this frame, but they move up to here. So you see there's no movement of the elbows, like you're in a plaster cast, up and down. And again, that's going to work the shoulders a little bit more. Shoulders really pull them back, really get those elbows in. Here we go, up and down. A bit like you're doing a sort of train, choo-choo train motion. And again, we've just been pulling these arms apart, so this is going to just be an absolute killer. It's our last set, we can do it. Can we do it? Last 16. 1. Focus. 2. Feel that burn in the shoulders. 3. 6. 8. We've got our last 8. Keep those elbows at the same angle. 4. 3. 2. 1. Oh my goodness. Lose the band. Let's roll the shoulders back. Can I have a nice, nice stretch, because we've really, really worked those arms. Just across and open. Maybe that one's got a slower song. Let's take one arm across. Oh, quite heart rate going up there as well. 115 BPM. So that was 160 calories doing that. When you work with resistance, your continued burning calories much longer after the class is finished. Let's turn that thumb down. Whereas cardio exercise is great, but once you stop working out, you don't often carry on. Whereas when you work with resistance, your muscles are working so much harder. Release. Oh, let's change side. My arms are like dead slabs of meat. Oh my goodness. Think of the summer tops we can wear, our nice toned arms. And more importantly, it's strengthening the shoulders. A lot of that stuff we did was quite rehabilitative, even though it doesn't feel like it, but it's all about strengthening the shoulders, not just having nice arms. Turn the thumb down. And also you want strong, stable joints so you avoid injury, especially I know you both got dogs. Throwing a ball is one of the things that messed up my arm because I'm not used to walking dogs. And when I walked your dog for a week, Penny, I ended up with a problem in my elbow. Release, because you're not used to that. So stretch back. And my arms, you can see they're hyperextensive. So because they bend back the wrong way, I have non-stable elbows. So I have to be really careful because it's really easy for injury. I'm just going to take this forward into a little lean. Let gravity do the work. I'm resting on my thighs. There's no stress on the legs. You can see my arms just about. Slowly coming up. Let's use triceps. So we're going to use the band to help stretch the shoulders out. I'm just trying to turn this down very slowly. So the bands can be useful for this as well. So I'm just gonna dangle the band down the back and then I should be able to grab this one. So I'm just trying to, this is the arm I'm stretching. I'm trying to pull the arm up. So you try and reach your hands together. So the arm that's around the back, so my right arm, is the one that's stretching in the shoulder. This top arm is just pulling it. It's a nice stretch. Sometimes it's hard to reach, so the bands do help. Nice, easy breathing. Lovely, let's switch sides. I'm just going to release the band. Hold the band the other way. Find it. Climb up with my hand as much as I can. And then I can create a bit more pressure if I need to, or just hold here. And try not to let the body do the work. Let the chest relax and let the arm be pulled back. So we're trying to flex, get some more flexibility in these shoulders. Oh, my arms are shaking. Release. Let's pull the arms forward, stretch. Let those shoulder blades really stretch and then just tuck the chin in. Release again. We can use the band to hold behind and stretch. Lift those arms up and reach back. Really stretching out that chest. The shoulders are pulled back. Release. Can release the band. I'll do a little shoulder stretch. So I'll take one arm up. If you see me, I'm going to grab this wrist and I'm going to just pull it up and lean over a little bit. And then change. So you're grabbing the wrist. So you're trying to stretch the shoulder more than bend at the waist. I've just got, here so you can see me, but you can have your feet together or not totally together. I am going to do a little side stretch now. This time stretching all the way over, so stretching all the way down the side. And lift up, let's change. Just going to do a tiny little neck loosener, because sometimes when we're working our arms, we tend to tense all around the neck. So let's just let the head look
right and left, gently, gently.
Back to centre, head gently side to side. Really gentle, just a little stretch. You're not trying to bend your ear to your shoulder. Just stretch and hold. Change side, gentle. Let's breathe to finish. And stretch back and release and breathe. And stretch back. Ooh, one more, excuse the noises. And back and give yourselves a clap. Well done, thank you, that was hard.
Thank you, Lee.